Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you all the different ways you can export photos from iPhoto. So I'm using iPhoto version 9.5 and I'm going to show you the export options. So there's tons of options to be able to share a photo and I'm not going to talk about those. I'm going to talk about if you select a single photo and you want to export it from your iPhoto library. Now at the end I'm going to show you the easiest, quickest, and maybe best way to do it. But for now, let's take a look at the options inside File Export because there's a lot of them. So we're going to concentrate right now on File Export. You can export photos as a web page or a video slideshow. But File Export is where you get your photos out and you can save them in the original format that they're in or JPEG or another format here. JPEG is probably what you want for most photos. You can select a quality option. You don't have more specifics here, but you can go medium, high, maximum. Medium is probably good enough if you're going to be sharing a photo by email or posting it to a web page. You can also include some things on the photo. We'll see how those turn out. And you can select the size. You can do full size, which is the original size of the photo, small, medium, large, or custom. And in custom, you can basically specify a maximum width, a maximum height, or just a maximum of one of the two. So let's just go to, say, a medium size photo. And then you can determine the type of file name you're going to use. Of course, you can change this very easily afterwards. So it's not that important. And if you're going to do several photos, if I had selected several, I could choose a prefix, say photo, and that would do photo 1, photo 2, photo 3. So let's export this photo here and save it to the desktop. So if we hide iPhoto, we can see there's the file on the desktop and we have it now. It's definitely a smaller size than before. We can actually look at it here. Command I tells us 65K, whereas if we were to go to iPhoto and let's say export that same photo, but let's do same quality, but for size, let's go to a large size and export, and then we'll call this with a slightly different name. Now when I hide, I've got two photos here and I can see this one is larger, obviously, not just in dimensions, but if I get information on this, I can see it's 65K for the smaller one and then 218K for the larger photo. Now I'm going to select another photo. This is one I took with my iPhone, so it has GPS information in it. When I export, I'm going to use the same options and I've got location information selected. Just to show you what that does, I'm going to export and then hide iPhoto and I'm going to double click on it to open it up in preview. In preview I'm going to use Command I to get information about it. And you can see all this information that's included with the JPEG. And I can click on GPS and sure enough it has the GPS location for this photo. If I had not checked that box off, GPS data would be blank in this exported version of the photo. Now I've been showing you how to export one photo, go into it and do file export, but you can export multiple photos, select them, select an entire event, entire album, all sorts of different ways you can select photos and then export, and then you're exporting all of these photos. So you can do them in groups just like that. Now exporting is great if you want to shrink the file down to post it on the web or send to a friend or do something else with it. But what if you want to get the original photo, the actual full resolution photo that you've got in iPhoto out of the iPhoto library and as a file in the Finder that you can use somewhere else? Well, there's two ways to do it, the hard way and the easy way. So let's select this photo here and export and do it the hard way. We can select kind as original and there we go. We're going to export now this file. And we could save it to the desktop and it's going to give us the original file out as a file by itself outside of the iPhoto library. But there's an easier way to do it. You could simply, this is the desktop, this is iPhoto, you can just drag and drop. And it's easy as that and you get the original that way. And you could do it with groups. So you want to get these three out here, drag and drop, and now there they are. You could put them into a Finder window, you can drag them onto a desktop, you can even drag them into other applications. So for instance, if I want to open this up in another app, I could simply drag and drop to any app that accepts a photo like preview. And there you go. I didn't have to export it and save it somewhere. I can just go right from iPhoto to another app.